So guys, the title of the video is kind of making people go off. And now we are starting with almost half the number of usual viewers that we start. Now we start with 18 viewers, and usually we start with around 30. So it's almost half, but probably my choice of, where's my tablet pen? Okay, it's here, the tablet pen, I found it. Because my desk, if you see my desk, you will be very disappointed, because Niku is... Yeah, my desk is similar to my desktop, by the way. It's hell. First, I want to show you this, which is the alien guy. I'm stuttering, I'm sure. Because this is... what is this? Cycles render. But this is the low poly. This is the low poly, and it's for cinematic, so it's kind of good looking. It doesn't look quite like a low poly. It's kind of smooth and everything. So yeah, this took me a while. This is probably, it doesn't seem like a very complex model. But as you saw from all the streams I did, maybe like 3 or 4 streams I did, making parts of this model, making UVs, didn't make the textures on stream, but I made them when I had the kind of an epiphany. I have something from above camera. Oh, I have to make textures, and I did the textures in Substance Painter. It's nothing too huge to make those textures. Let's see it a little bit up closer. Yeah, he has even some kind of a, skin, which is from the texture. I didn't make it in Blender. Making skin pores in Blender is a little bit overkill for Blender, and Blender will kill your machine most likely. So it's better to be made afterwards in the texture, if you can. And in Substance Painter, it's pretty easy, but whatever. Let's remove something, by the way. Let's remove the skirt, for example. I will select the skirt. And I will just, yeah, we have pants. Let's remove this. Okay, amazing. We can remove stuff and still he's looking good. So, okay, yeah, this is the guy. Let me save it and then close it so it doesn't interfere. This guy on the Pure file here is our purpose today. We need to do some stuff. I'm not sure what stuff I will do. But for example, what I'm a little bit, not anxious to do, I don't want to do it, but I have to, is those things here on the details here. Those borders on the cape, for example. We might try to do them, but let me show you the cape, how it's done. The cape itself is kind of done in a very bad way. It's just from one plane, and I just subdivided where I need to, and I made the cape. Okay, the cape is fine. It's not looking good. We cannot select a border, for example. But what we can do, at least what we can try to do, is select the edges here. And we will see if this will work. If this works, it will be great. So select those edges. Shift deduplicate them. And move them on Z-axis just a little bit. Just a little bit. Okay, now. I don't know why they are doubled. Let me see what's happening here. Okay, they're not doubled. Or they're... Ah! Because I have the... Okay, it's not a problem. Let's P selection, which means I, extract it to another mesh. And then I... disable the solidify modifier. Now we have just an edge, which is great. But what Niku will do with an edge? Nobody knows. But let's try to extrude it, for example, and then just S to scale it inwards. Okay, it's a start, and then we move it up and back. Okay, this is what we want. So now I have to go to the toilet. No, I'm joking. I have to go to scope mode, and then manually I will make it the width I want. Let's see what width we have. This is a very good concept, by the way, here, because we have a back view, we had side view, we have every views, which is rare, and it's great that we have them. For example, for the alien, I didn't have all the views, but it was an interesting project anyway. So you can see from this concept, I did what I just showed you a couple of minutes ago, and yeah, sometimes the concept doesn't exactly look as the final model, as you can see. But with my experience, with my anatomy knowledge and everything, I can use the concept and create something like I showed you. It's, yeah, someday I will do this or similar dragon, but with less detail. Just do it from scratch, then retopologize it, of course, with the help of the quadrimesher, yeah. And then UV map and bake it in Substance Painter. Hopefully it will work, we'll see. We will see. But for now, let's concentrate on the task at hand, which is this guy. Let's see some comments. Nico, too lazy to clean your desktop. Yeah, too lazy to clean my desktop and my desk top also. The top of my desk is pretty much a lot of things on it. It has. Yeah, by the way, just before I start the stream, I manually renewed the promo links on each of my promo videos in my other channel of all of my courses, except for two courses, by the way. But most of the courses, I renewed the promo links now. Every month I have to do this. Every month on the 12th of the month, I'm doing this renewing of this courses. The promo links, I mean. I'm creating a new promo code and I am putting the promo link manually on each video, under each video in the description. It's a very dirty job, but somebody has to do it, you know. So the nice thing here is that our border line, or whatever this is called, is pretty low poly, so it's easier to work with it and not make it crumble or wavy or whatever. That's why I prefer to work with low polys. Of course, we need to manually adjust it, as I'm doing right now, but it doesn't matter too much. Sometimes I'm pressing Alt-Z, as you can see, so to see inside, so I can pull it from inside. Otherwise, Blender just don't want to pull it if I don't press Alt-Z, usually. Blender is sometimes not so cooperative, we may say. But it's all about the user. I mean, this is a program. It behaves in a certain way. If you know how to use it, you will be able to utilize all its possibilities. So Blender, it's mostly not Blender fault if something doesn't work. Usually it's the behind computer device, which is yourself. Or in this case, myself. So let's not blame Blender for anything. Especially while it's absolutely free. We can blame ZBrush for everything though, because it's a paid program. Also 3D Max we can blame for, even for the war in Ukraine, we can blame 3D Max because it's very expensive for what it's offering. So we can blame it for everything. 3D Max is important, it's 3D Max is, everything is 3D Max's fault. What I'm saying, yeah. Everything from the death of dinosaurs, from the ice age and the big flood until recent times, the war in Ukraine, and even more recently the heating of things in Israel, you know, all those things 3D Max is responsible. Yeah, Blender doesn't have anything to do with it. You know, when you are a free program, you can get away with everything. Even Blender can go and kill somebody. Nobody will say Blender is responsible. No, they will say, ah, it's okay, Blender is free. So, yeah. So being a free software is a good thing. Let's enable the solidify modifier because I want to see how far away this is from the cape itself. And I want it to be a little bit further away. Although this border has to have detail on its own, which is interesting, but we have to do it. What Nico will do with the edge? Nico is the edge. Ooh. ZBrush is better for hyper-realistic characters. I would agree on that, yeah. Hi Nico, I want to ask if I can review your head sculpting course in a YouTube video. I learned a lot from that course and I won't share the course's paid content. No, you can share everything. If the video is short, you cannot share the whole course, of course. So you can share the paid content also. Doesn't matter. It's okay. If you don't share the whole course, of course, or half of the course. If you share like 10% of the course or less, I think it's fine. Okay. I'm thinking to switch to Blender from ZBrush and Maya. Is there any similar tool in Blender like confirmed tool in Maya? I don't know. Confirmed tool in Maya. I haven't used ever Maya, so I cannot answer this question. Hi, I watched your course about the female and male anatomy. I learned so much every time. It's clear and fast. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I mean, it's not for all people like this. Some people are hating. Not hating, but they are haters. Probably not haters for everything, but they're haters for my courses. Because I have sometimes for my courses like 1-star or 3-star reviews, which are hurting the overall rating, of course. But when people feel this way, you cannot do anything about it, you know. You cannot change their mind very easy. You can change their mind, but I have to go and, you know, with some guns and probably knives and find their house. It's a pain in the ass. Probably it's better to say we cannot change their mind, you know. Yeah, it's difficult. Difficult. And also, I'm not a violent person usually. Although, since I have grown up in a family of military men, my father was a military guy, so he was kind of practicing the military education on myself, which doesn't make you very emotionally intelligent. So my emotions are not ultra, how to say, big. I'm not big on emotions, but we may say that all the Balkan people are like this, most of them, because of our way of life here, what it was. Nowadays it's probably a little bit different, but back in the days, no, emotions were something that you cannot afford. You cannot afford emotion. Let me see if we have a border inside. No, we don't have a border inside, which is interesting. I have to ask them, because we are constantly going back and forward. I'm showing them screenshots. They are giving me feedbacks. For example, the face was like the concept. So a little bit older, a little bit more drunk looking guy. But then they show me he has to look like this guy. That's why I took the matters in my own hand and just made him look more like the picture instead of the concept, which they approved, so it's okay. And then we moved on from there. So let's see what this color is, if we can. Yes, we can. I'm moving it a little by a little. A little by a little, huh? Is it good English? Yes. Si, si. Molto bene, molto bene. No, molto bene is in Italian. Mucho gusto, mucho gusto. Si. Yo hablo español. No problema. Nico, what is this? I've swore that I've seen that sculpt somewhere on the channel before, but I can't seem to find it now. I'm not sure you have seen it. Probably you have. But who knows? Is it for 3D print? Yes, this is for 3D print. Hello, Nico. How's going? What advice can you give for someone who is burned out, lost motivation to get back to 3D sculpting? I cannot give you a motivation. The motivation, you have to find it in yourself. Watch some videos, watch some of my streams, and maybe you can kind of inspire yourself. But you have to come from within. From outside, it's difficult. Probably it is somewhere there. The motivation is there, but it's kind of like charcoal. It's cold charcoal above, but below, in the deep, there is something that's warm and it's waiting to burn into flames. And you have to find a way to dig it out, you know, somehow with going to our station, just inspiring yourself, what the other people are doing. Yeah. People who don't like your courses probably have no sense of humor. Yeah, but there are people like this, you can agree. There are people without sense of humor. And also there are people without my type of sense of humor, which is normal because we are different people. So if my sense of humor is a little bit more rough, probably, or I don't know what it is exactly, then yeah, some people have more refined sense of humor, and they're just like this villager. He doesn't do it quite right, you know. I will put 1-star review, and he will suffer. Peasant. I really love watching you live during my work because your jokes are hilarious. Thank you very much. Yeah, Henico, it's good to see you live again. I miss your jokes very much. But I'm not throwing too much jokes these days, right? Yeah, I'm getting a depressed person. I'm joking, of course. This is a joke. This is a joke. I'm not depressed. I may be depressed at some point. You know, there are certain things that can happen in a person's life that can be very depressing. Of course, the most obvious example is a death of a close relative, for example. It's very devastating. I'm sure. I have been through something like this when I was younger. My cousin died. We were very close. He was my best friend. And we were like 20, 23 years old, something like this. It was very, very bad, but I was young. When you are young, things can be bad, but then they can get good pretty quickly, and it's not like this. When you're getting older, your nerve system probably is a little bit more damaged, and then all the factors that are damaging it even more may destroy it, you know, and you may lose your mind or something like this. God forbid. We may say nobody, I guess, wants to lose their mind, but sometimes when you are in a huge amount of stress, as I said, if some of your relatives died or is suffering, or you got some very bad news from the doctors for yourself, for example, and your mind probably can just switch off or just go to some other place. And then they will call you crazy and they will laugh at you, which is obviously not the best. But at least you will not be suffering that much anymore, probably. I'm not sure, you know. Hopefully we will not know ever. So, yeah, I'm just touching this. Let's go to the box. The box has to look like the concept. So it has to have these curves and everything. So let's try at least to do it. It has to be done in poly modeling. So I will go like this, Control R, and add some polygons like this. Edges, of course, not polygons, edge loops. And just watch the concept closely and try to replicate it. And yeah, well, I'm doing this because the artist that does the concept, he's giving me feedback. And he said, if I were you, I would go and you know, make the curves like the concept in the pizza box, which is great, and I'm doing it. Yeah, I like exact and you know, exact feedback. So you have to do this and this. Okay, I'm fine with it. It's not a problem. Maybe sometimes it's a little bit passive aggressive, can be the feedback. But I deserve it. I will say I deserve it because myself, I am sometimes. a little bit arrogant, a little bit passive aggressive, I may say that. You know, when you get good in something, at some point you realize you are kind of good in something. And then when people are trying to give you some hard time, I tend to get a little bit irritated and I get a little bit passive aggressive, sometimes not so passive aggressive. But I think it's a human trait, you know. Many people think, oh, Nico, he's such a good guy. Yes, but everything is, this is like a mirror, you know. When somebody is good and it's respectful and everything, I am good and respectful and everything. When people are starting to get in a certain way, not so good, not so respectful, then I also start to get like this. So it's normal, we may say. Let me see this pizza box, how it looks from the side view. Okay, it's curvy this way. We can curve it a little bit more. Probably because it's good to be curved a lot, because it is hot pizza inside and it's melting the cardbox around it, which is great. I mean, yeah, it's interesting. So the back of the pizza, obviously it's a little bit thinner than the top. I hope this helps you people. I mean, when I'm making this, I'm just expressing what I think when I am working and when I am looking at the concept and how to interpretate the concept. Some English words are just messing up with my tongue, you know. I'm like, concept. We can interpret the concept very much. It's not a problem at all. Here we have to make the fingers a little bit thicker because it's a cartoon character. It's a cartoonized real character though. I think this is some kind of YouTuber. I'm not sure exactly because I don't know this guy. But this is a real person, as you saw from the reference. And he's obviously doing something with food. But, you know, this I don't have to know. I have a pretty clear concept and I will just follow it. And I think we'll get there. Hopefully the guys with the alien, with the blue alien, are happy now with the result. And we will finish that project so I can concentrate more on this one. And then people, you will ask, but when will be the next course? For now, I'm not doing next course. I'm not working on the next course. Although the next course I'm planning to be on hands and arms. But I'm not doing it. Because I am lazy and I have freelances and stuff like this. And also I want to concentrate more on the YouTube channels. So you see, I'm streaming a little bit more often. And yeah. By the way, I have to, if I don't forget, show you a few of my older works, which I already uploaded on the computer, so I have them. Older, I mean when I was 16, when I was maybe 10 years old, I have works, and they are here. Of course, they are not on Blender or 3D Max or ZBrush. They're on a notebook or some kind of a paper. Yeah. Basically, yes. So this what he's holding, I'm thinking it's a piece of this pizza. So this pizza inside would be a whole pizza, you know, but without one piece. This one piece will be on I don't know how it is in English. No, I probably know, but I cannot remember quite how this is called in English. In Bulgarian is jezel, a scepter. Something like a scepter, most likely it is. So we have this thing here going on the back. Let's connect it, by the way. How to connect it? It's very easy. Just delete this part. Select those edges and press F. If you don't have the F2 add-on turned on, probably you will not be able to do that. But if you have it, Yesterday, I was wondering how to get my model in Blender to work properly and look as in Substance Painter. Because in Substance Painter, the blue alien looks very good. But in Blender, manually, I couldn't get it to work good. But I found a video, which is a couple of minutes long. The guy explains how, from Substance Painter, how to export, and in Blender, how to import it very quickly and very efficiently. And everything worked pretty much flawlessly. So probably I should do the same video, stealing from his video, which is okay. Of course, I will mention his video on my video. Basically, I will copy his video, but with my translation. It's in English. His video is in English, by the way. So what translation? It's not a translation. I'll just do it by myself. But I'm just thinking about it. I'm not doing it right now. I'm just thinking about it. So here we need to have more detail. But I'm not very, you know, I'm not going to do it very fast. Because now I have to apply the solidify modifier and then I can do this other detail, which is those yellow lines here around this other lines. They will be a little bit difficult to do, but we can do them or not. Basically, we'll see. How do you select a new object without having to go to object mode? Alt and Q. And you go hover the object, Alt and Q. Nice to see you final streaming. I can't seem to always get you live here in the Philippines. Yeah. Basically, in Asia, when I'm streaming late, in Asia, they are sleeping, so you cannot, yeah. I think when it comes to feedback, there's a huge difference between someone telling you, please change this or that, and you made this wrong. Yeah, you made this wrong is, it's very much easier to feedback, but even I sometimes cannot pinpoint the mistake very much. So even I sometimes say, this seems wrong. And I cannot say what exactly it is. Nico, how many hours of work per day in the company as a 3D character artist? How many of hours? It's 8 hours work day usually. But of course, in 8 hours, usually you work like 5 hours or something. But if you have a lot of work, sometimes in game companies, you can work for even 12 hours a day for a certain period of time when you have to push it so the game came out or certain revision of the game came out. Separate the edge border, convert to curves, set the extrude level in curves, and how other solidify modifiers you will be able to control all the non-destructive. Yeah, I know, but since this is pretty low poly, I can control it non-destructively with just sculpt mode. It's not very bad. I mean, it's easy. But Nico, do you a strategy on how to deal with nitpicking difficult clients or directors? No. Even I sometimes bump into difficult clients, but for myself, it's easy because I can say, screw it, I will not work with you at some point. For example, we start working, I'm doing something for them, and usually when there's a big company, I cannot do my usual payment plan, which is first I get like 30% of the money, then I get at certain point of the development of the freelance, I will get in the middle 20 more percent, and then at the end 50%. Usually the big companies pay at the end the whole amount, which for me is not very nice because sometimes I lose a will to work if I don't get any money. And if the clients are very picky, for example, for things that I don't think are worth it to be picky of, I am saying, okay, look, I have done this amount of work. If you want this, for example, I'm almost done with the high poly. I have to do the low poly by plan, but they are very picky. They are doing stuff. And I'm like, okay, see, choose another guy. Don't pay me. I will not give you anything. So choose somebody else. But usually they say, oh, no. Give us at least the high poly, how much it will cost. I say, it's this amount of money and I will give you the high poly. And sometimes this happens. But if you are new and kind of a new character artist and you don't have a name in the industry yet, then probably this will be a little bit harder. And then you shouldn't be that picky, and you should kind of get over your ego a little bit more, which is, by the way, getting over your ego is a very good practice, because your ego will get you in more trouble than not. The ego is something that we in Eastern Europe have a lot of it, but it's not getting us too much good. Egomaniacs. So yeah, try to not be so much egocentric and just work with people and you will be fine, even if they're difficult. Hello from the Alps. Oh, my sister is living in the Alps, by the way, in the Austrian Alps, in a very nice house in the Alps, surrounded by green and kind of a big mountains, everything very nice. Hello, Nico from Turkey. You are a gift to this community. Thank you for your effort. May I ask, what is the value that you use for focal length for view? Right now, I'm using 88, I think. Let me see. Usually, I'm using... No, 99 is in this case. But usually, I'm using 88. 99 is okay, fine. Some people I see, what they are doing some realistic sculpts in Blender. Like our guy... Stefan Hartmann, he is using 105, I think, for focal length. So you will be able to control the height and deepness at any time. But at some point, I have to go and apply the solidify modifier and everything will go to hell. But that's life. That's the life. This is Korn, by the way, if you don't recognize the song. Korn, That's the Life. It's a pretty good song, by the way. I started to realize these days that metal music is for people with issues. And I love metal music. And I realize I have issues also, yeah. But I don't know if you can be a very, very good artist, devoted on your craft, if you don't have issues. Most of the people that I know that are amazing in their craft, I mean character artists mostly, they have even more issues than me. And I'm starting to think that if you have to be very good in something, the more issues you have, the better you will be in this craft. But yeah. Maybe I'm wrong, I don't know, but this is my observation. If you don't have issues, if you are not kind of introvert person a little bit, if you are not kind of self-sufficient, then it will be difficult, because being a good artist means spending a lot of time alone practicing, which people who are very social and like to go out just cannot do. That's logical, you know. So logic says that in order to be a good artist, you need to be a psychopath. I always say that, but not complete psychopath, I may say. But the more psychopath you are, the better artist you will be. Of course, that probably it's not exactly true. I'm hoping that's not true. Because for some of you who are not that much psychopathic, doesn't have this psychopathic thing, so lack of emotions sometimes, cannot understand the emotions of others. So if you don't have that, you will be like, okay, but so I cannot be a character artist because I'm more sensitive and I care about other people, so I cannot be an artist. And probably that's true. I'm sorry to say that. Who knows? Nobody knows. Nobody can tell you what you can or you cannot be. It's just... you will decide with your actions, with your motivation, and with your kind of hundreds, thousands of hours of sculpting, you will decide what you want to be. Now I will do something very drastic and you will see, and probably some of you will pass out. So hold yourself, breathe. And what I will do is I will apply the modifiers on the cape. I know this is drastic and this probably will bite me in the ass, but I'm doing it anyway. Why? You will ask, but Nico, why did you do that? Now you cannot go back ever. But I just want to do this, you know. I just want to, very hard to do a wrinkle in this area. I don't know why, but just want. And maybe here I will do a wrinkle like this. And those wrinkles, as you can see, they are pretty, you know, low poly. But we have to have them, because otherwise we will not have them. Yeah. Nico is pretty logical, I know. Nico is the most logical guy I know. Probably not. I know very logical guys, by the way. My father is a very, very logical guy. And he always say, I'm always right. Which means a couple of things. He's egocentric, obviously. And also he's really a logical guy. But his logic is not always the right logic. Which everybody should consider. Your logic may be not the logic of the things you are looking at and you are trying to, you know, understand. Nico, how much hours to take to sculpt realistic head? And what with the base shape? So, for me, to sculpt a realistic head without pores, but realistic, with good-looking realistic head, probably it will take me about 5-6 hours. Just the base of the head, without too much detail, it will take me like 1 or 2 hours. But then I have to, if I have to, you know, make some likeness a little bit more, because for perfect likeness, I don't know if I can do perfect likeness. Because perfect likeness means you have to do a lot of things. For example, you have to gather enormous amount of references. And then you have to put your references over your sculpt with some transparency. Look at very tiny differences. You have to adjust your field of view to match the photo in order to make it perfect, and then adjust, then another photo and put it and adjust. I don't like that. This for me is not exactly art. But yeah, ego is the end boss. Yeah, it's very difficult to overcome, but you don't have to overcome it completely. The ego you have to be able to control, not to delete. You cannot delete your ego, but even if you could, it's not healthy. You have to have some amount of it, but you have to be able to press the button. No ego this time. It's fine. I'm not sure I can make it yet, but I'm working on it. I'm making a character for animation. Is there a way to make simulated hairs to look kind of realistic? I don't know about hairs, by the way. If you have seen my streams and everything, I'm avoiding realistic hair like a plague. I'm avoiding it more than I was avoiding going out during the COVID times. I'm avoiding it more than I'm avoiding jumping out of the window from the third floor. No, I'm in the fifth floor. So from the fifth floor. I'm avoiding it, so I cannot explain it, you know. Can I get your Discord? Yes, you can. It's in the description of this video, I think. If I'm wrong, sorry. But also my courses are in the description of this video if somebody is interested, you know. And you can support me because I am hungry. No, now, exactly now, I'm not hungry at all. Why? Because I was able to eat today, which is great because somebody bought my course. One of my courses was bought yesterday and today I was able to eat. It's great. And if somebody buys my course today, I will be able to pay for my internet even. And maybe I will be able to eat tomorrow or in the weekend. But we'll see. We'll see. Everything is in the hands of God, some people say. But I don't believe in God. So everything is in the hands of faith. I don't know. You can call it God or you can call it faith. Maybe some people who believe in God will take this offensively, but I'm not offending you. I'm not offending your gods. It's fine. Everybody who believes, it's okay to believe. I even think that people who believe in God, but really believe, not just say I believe in God, but really believe in God, they're better people because they are going through this rule book, which is the Bible or the Quran or whatever book is of their God. And these rule books usually are making you a better person. They're saying, get down with your ego, don't steal, turn the other cheek, for example, which is exactly, turn the other cheek is literally overcoming your ego. Because somebody slaps you, and then your ego says, like, this guy slaps me, I have to kill him, right? Something like this. But you overcome your ego, you calm down, you don't go to his anger level, and you just turn the other cheek and say, you slap me here, now do it on the other cheek. And if you can do that, I don't think there are many people that can do that, but if you can do that, I envy you. Definitely. It's, yeah, I admire you even if you can do that. But in a real situation, because if your kid slaps you and then you turn the other cheek, it's not the same. But if some guy on the street who is drunk or who is something comes and you fucking bitch and slaps you in the face, and then if you can turn the other cheek, you're the best. Because the weakness is to answer with violence, you know. This is weakness. You are not strong enough to sustain yourself. Because as somebody in the chat said, the ego is the end boss, and it's the worst to overcome. You can overcome your fear. For example, somebody slaps you and you go running. You can overcome that fear and you can stand up and fight. But to stand and not fight and just say, okay, if you want, hit me. That's the most difficult problem. And we need challenges, you know, to develop ourselves. We need challenges. We need hardship. If things are very easy for us, we will be just one cell organisms. You know, we will not be humans. We will be amoebas. And yeah, that's the like. Are your kids didn't believe too? My kids, I don't know. They're kids, you know. You don't know. You don't know how they will develop. If they want to believe in God, let them. If they want to believe in something else, let them. I will guide them to what I think is right, but I will not say you have to become this, you have to become non-believer, you have to become atheist, you have to become a God person. No. They, from their perspective, from their minds, they will see the world in their way and they will choose whether to become gay or to become normal or to become yeah, maybe gays are normal too, but whatever. So to become whatever, they can become God person, they can become no. And yeah, I will turn to this. When I say gay and normal, it's because in when I was younger, especially in the communist times, and after that, of course, we are this burden from the communist time is much closer to us. The communist times ended 34 years ago, I think. But we started to develop a little bit like freer mindset just like 15 years ago or something like this. So it's still for us normal is to be a man or a woman and to become something else is not normal, you know. To be a man and like men, it was not normal at all. Nowadays, it's considered normal. But yeah, for me, I don't know. I read about it, by the way, and people say, and scientists say that gay thinking So thinking like the other sex is developed in the womb, so you cannot control it actually. So you are born gay, usually. There are people probably that are gays because it's modern or whatever, but I'm sure that most real gay persons, they are born like this. And there are scientific evidences that this can happen in the womb because of certain hormones and stuff like this. And yeah, a guy can be born with the mindset of a girl. And that, especially back in the days, was horrible because they were constantly told that this is not normal, this is abnormal, this is absolutely insanity and abomination. And they were hiding themselves and they were always with huge issues. Nowadays, it's better. It's definitely better for this. Freedom is always good, by the way. I like freedom. You can be free to be anything you want these days, almost. Not in my country exactly, but in more developed countries. Yeah. Not in Russia also, but in more developed countries, yes. Yeah, and I'm sorry about the Russian people, but come on. You know what it is. You know how it is in Russia. Just landed on a stream and first thing is gay or normal. Exactly. Yeah. Sometimes you can hear those things here in the stream. Nick Riketa reading from the book of bread tube. Maybe, maybe. How do you select a new object without having to? Okay, we saw that. Nico getting cancelled. Yeah. Please don't get cancelled. How the Nico good working there? Yeah, thank you. Hormones in the womb, how testosterone, lack of it. Exactly, yes. No imagination, I think it was out and cute. Exactly. This is my first time coming to your stream and I'm hearing religion, gay and normal. What a great introduction to a stream. Exactly. Are there some people that still prefer communist? Yes, there are a lot of people in my country that prefer communism than this. And those are people who doesn't have any future. They don't know how to do anything. They are mostly not very intelligent. And those are people who are always haters. They're hating everything. They're hating the government. They're hating their neighbors who are better than them. They're hating everyone who is above them, which is almost everybody. And those people, they want the communist times back because in communist times, in theory, everybody is equal. And in practice, it's not like this. But in theory, everybody is equal and they want equality. They want to do nothing and to have something. In communist time, in capitalist time or democracy, you cannot do that. You have to work, you have to work hard. The harder you work, the more you will have, usually. Especially if you work kind of a job with more of your brain, because otherwise, I don't know. My father oftentimes romanticized the good old times in the Soviet Union, but I think it's because things were shitty there and things are also shitty now. But advertisement is better now. Yes. Why did you decide to become agnostic atheist? I'm atheist too. I don't know if I'm atheist or whatever. I don't know. I don't consider myself an atheist because atheists usually they promote their atheism, as long as I understand. I'm not sure. I don't promote anything. I say you are you. You can believe in whatever you want. I am myself. I can believe in whatever I want. And if we want to have a nice friendly conversation about it, it's okay. It's a topic of many discussions. We can discuss it forever. And it will help me understand you more, and it will help you understand me if you want, of course, but it will almost never lead to somebody changing their opinion about the subject. That's my viewpoint. So what's the point? What's the point of trying to change somebody? What's the point of trying to push your religion views to other people? I don't know what's the point. You are trying to free them or something. Don't. Just believe in what you want and be a good person. That's enough. I am trying to be a good person, even without beliefs or something. But of course, it's probably easier if you have beliefs. If I believe in God, I will go through and, you know, follow the Bible, follow His will, follow His... and I'm saying about the Christian God, because I'm not that familiar with the Muslim God, the Allah, or I don't know what names he can have, a lot of names, I guess. I'm not super familiar with that. Although we have a lot of Muslims in Bulgaria. Bulgaria is a diversified country, we may say. We have a lot of Muslim people. In the place that I was born, the city that I was born, is surrounded by villages, and in those villages, people are talking Turkish. They're Turkish people. And in my village that I grown up, we went to that village like every few weeks when we were in vacation. We were spending a lot of time there. In this village, there were like 5 or 6 Bulgarian families. So people who doesn't know Turkish were just 5 or 6 families. The other village, the other whole village was Turkish people. And I always say this story when I was going to the bread house. There was just a house, they bake bread inside. It was amazing. I mean, the smell outside is just amazing. Fresh bread, you know, fresh baked bread. And there's just a little window and they sell bread from there. And there's the line, and I'm on the line and I'm waiting and I'm hearing people, how they order the bread. Birekmek. Birekmek is one bread in Turkish, but I didn't know that. And I was like, what? These people are speaking some strange language. I don't know this language. How will I order bread? Because I was small, and they sent me to buy bread. And when I get to this window, and I was like asking for one bread in Bulgarian. And it turns out that the woman inside, she knew Bulgarian too. But they know, of course. But I didn't know that. I was a little boy back then. When you are little, many things are scary. Many things are strange. And then you grow old. And then much more things become scary and strange. So yeah, circle of life. Yeah, there is nothing like circle of life in this, but whatever. Sometimes to practice the religion is requires pushing it on others. I hope that there is nothing in any religion book that says you have to push this religion to others. Because then this religion becomes drastic or... like those people who are fighting in Syria, the Islamic country and stuff. Those, in my opinion, those people are not real believers. They are fanatics, which is a type of abomination of religion. They are led by people who have interests, and they have interest, those people, to be fanatics. Those people to be with twisted beliefs. And they believe blindly, but they believe in twisted things. Because what person who believes in any God, who is a nice person, will cut the head of another person? This is, I don't know. I don't find it cool, to say the least. Why do you decide to become... Okay, yes. How to deal with people who give backhanded compliments saying my skill level is basic but my execution is good but still simple. Those people are haters. They are passive-aggressive. They're trying to make themselves look better, probably. But it doesn't mean that they're wrong, for example. They may be right. But the way that they're saying it is... probably wrong, but this is coming from me. I am kind of this kind of person. Not exactly. I'm trying to be, as a teacher, to be more, let's say, not so aggressive. I'm not aggressive, of course, but not to be so rude. And I'm always saying, somebody asked me, can I have your thoughts on one of my models? And I say, if you are ready to cry and be depressed, be my guest. It was a joke, of course. Then the guy showed me and the model was looking pretty cool. And I said, this looks pretty cool to me. So I'm always joking about this. But if I was younger, many people would be crying right now with my reviews and feedbacks. But since I'm a little bit older, a little bit wiser now, things are different. When you get into your 40s, you start to think about other things. You start to get your ego a little bit aside, but not too much aside, sadly. We'll see. I'm working on it. I'm saying that I'm working on it. You know, it's very easy to say those things that I'm saying when nobody is in front of me and nobody can oppose me. Yeah, I'm reading your comments, I'm answering, but really, there is no conversation. It's one-sided from me. So I can be very relaxed. I can be relaxed, and when I'm relaxed, I can look very peaceful and very nice. But when I get angry, I don't look like this. Nobody looks good and peaceful and relaxed when they're angry. Except for Mickey Mouse, probably. I don't know. But yeah, most people, when they're angry, they look scary. So yeah. A couple of weeks ago, I was driving with my car in the city. And I made a mistake. And I cut somebody. And he was honking behind and everything. And when I make a mistake, since I don't consider myself the best driver ever, I say, okay, I made a mistake. If I can say sorry, I will say sorry. So in the next traffic light, I stopped next to him. I had the place in front of me and I may go, but I just stopped next to him and I opened my window and I looked at him. And I say like this, and he looked at me, and he was scared by my face, you know, somehow. And he didn't open his window, he just waved a little bit and went off. But before that, he was honking like crazy, you know. The only thing I wanted to say to him was like, I'm sorry, man, it was my fault, sorry. But people, obviously, these days, they don't expect that. Probably he expected me to, like, start screaming at him and what are you honking about and stuff. But if I am guilty, I'm guilty. That's it. Once, police stopped me because I was... I was in the village and I went to pass a car and the marking on the road was to not pass, so it was one line, so you cannot pass another car. But I passed it and they stopped me. I passed it right in front of them. It was stupid, but I didn't saw them. So I stopped and I was with my baby. It was probably around 14 years ago, because the baby now is 14 years old, man. And the baby and my former wife back then. And they stopped me. And I say, what did you do? And I say, guilty. So they say, come. And I went and stand right next to their car. But I was next to their car. They left their window a little bit open on my side. And they were talking inside, but loud. They say, what to do now with this guy? We have to give him ticket, a big ticket. And the other guy say, but he's a... So one guy is playing a good cop, the other guy was playing the bad cop. But, you know, it was supposed that I don't hear them, but they made sure that I heard them. And they were taking this conversation and they came to me and say, what will we do? And I say, whatever you say, because it's, I'm wrong, I will pay the price, give me a ticket. And they say, okay, we will give you just a small ticket, like 20 level, like 10 euro or something. And I say, okay, this is your choice. I say, I was wrong, so whatever is the punishment, of course, in the normal circumstances, I will take it. And yeah, they were trying to, you know, to make me give a bribe, for example. But I was not going to give them a bribe, you know. When I make a mistake, I will pay for it, but not with a bribe, usually. If I make a very huge mistake, for example, don't think that I'm an angel or something, no. If I make a very bad mistake, for example, I'm driving in a highway, which the speed limit is around 140 kilometers an hour. 140 is a speed limit in a highway in here in Bulgaria. So I'm driving in a highway with 140 kilometers an hour exact. I like to drive exactly on the speed limit, not below it too much. Exactly. So I'm driving, but there is certain part of the highway that the speed limit is 90 kilometers an hour. So 50 kilometers below the real speed limit, but there are signs and everything. But for example, I don't see them, and then they're waiting there, because in Bulgaria they usually do that. They're waiting where you don't expect them, but to make big money. So if they stop me there, and for this, like 50 kilometers above the speed limit in this area, I would have to pay like a big fine and a lot of points for my driver lessons, and maybe they will even take my driver's license for, let's say, a couple of months. So if they ask me for, let's say, 50 euro or something, I probably will do that, because in Bulgaria corruption is still pretty normal. And I know some of you, like from Brazil, from India, from those countries, from Russia, Ukraine, it's normal for your countries too, probably. For some people from Germany, from Switzerland, from United States, probably this is not that normal. But in our countries, corruption is pretty normal. My graphic tablet is... somebody asked how long do your graphic tablet last. Mine is 2 years old and has some scribbles on it. My tablet, I think I changed it 1.5 years ago. So it's probably 1.5 year old and it has some scribbles, but they're not something to brag about too much. It's fine. It's still working. It's cool. Show us your angry mode. Nobody wants to see anybody's angry mode, I think. We want to be peaceful, relaxed, and do stuff. Now, you can see that in this stream, particularly this one, I'm mostly speaking, and I'm not doing too much work. I'm just touching here, touching there. But, it's an interesting topic, just life and certain things about life. Maybe at some point when AI takes over, I will change my channel to be about life, about exercise, about food, about how to live your life, about how to live with other people peacefully, and many things that are interesting for me right now. And I am... especially when you are living in a family and you're trying to make a healthy family, you will always get these things and you will think about them, you will read about those things if you are smart enough, because nowadays in internet you can read about everything. You have so much knowledge in your hands, you have to just grab it and put it in your head. If you don't do that, you will have problems and you will not know why. But if you read, you will know why. You will still have problems, but you will know why. Which is great. I mean, knowledge is power. I got the power. Power. studio. Nico, have you seen the Brazilian film Elite Squad? It's very good and tells the reality of Rio de Janeiro. I was in Rio, so I know the reality of Rio de Janeiro. I was in the favelas. I was sleeping in a favela for, let's say, 5 days or 6 days. And the reality is, it was not bad. I mean, if you don't look like sheep, nobody will try to hunt you. Let's say that. If you are looking normal, bright, smiling, waving to people, usually, yeah, there were some people, shady people, who are trying to convince us to lead us to some place, to show us something, like a mountain. And but I'm from Bulgaria. It's these people, you can smell them. You can, when you see them, you know them. So it's kind of a good thing to be grown in this kind of a psycho environment, a psychopathic environment, which was the communist times, because then you kind of know what's happening. Because there are people from Western Europe that when they go to such place like a favela in Rio de Janeiro, they probably will, and they are, we saw them. There are people who are sleeping in our room exactly when we are going out of it. We are traveling to Argentina. And the same evening, we saw those two, boy and girl, with their suitcase in the favela. And then we understand that they are for our house, but we saw them. We tried to speak with them because we saw they are tourists like us, but they were so looking so scared. They were looking like they're like rabbits in the wolf den or something like this. And even if you feel like rabbit in the wolf den, you cannot look like this. You have to look different. You have to look like other wolves. You have to put a mask on a wolf in order to survive in the wolf den, even if you're a rabbit, you know. That's the thing. And they were looking like rabbits, you know. I don't know what happened to them. Probably they're okay. Because back then, when I was in Brazil, the favelas were peaceful. Especially this favela, just above Copacabana beach. It was amazing view. I mean, the favela people are living in the best spots in Rio de Janeiro. They're on the height. They have amazing view. From our favela, from the house, the top of the house, we were seeing Jesus Christ. We were seeing Copacabana and Ipanema. We were seeing everything almost. Except for Sugar Mountain because it was covered by another mountain, but still Sugarloaf Mountain, I think it was called, yeah. I really like you, Nico. Thank you very much. Hello, dear Nico. Thank you for sharing your experience and thoughts with us. I'm from Iran. Yeah, Iran is cool. I haven't been in Iran, by the way. I have to go. I like Arab food a lot. You're crazy like me or a passionate like me. Yeah, passionate. I'm not sure I am passionate for anything except for knives and sculpting, making characters and all this craft. But yeah, that's passionate, right? Yeah. Bulgaria is great, especially in the summer, to live near the sea. Yeah. What city are you in, by the way? Same in Russia. Honestly, almost better this way. I'm from Shumen is called my city. Shumen in Bulgaria means noisy. So the city name is noisy. But in Bulgaria, Shumen. It means like noisy city. But whatever, it's not so noisy. It's near, it's like 100, 120 kilometers from the sea. So it's not super near the sea. But it's still cool. It's still cool. It's pretty cool in the winters. It's very cold. Do you have fear of the AI things, the future of AI? Greetings from Colombia. Ooh, Colombia. Don't worry. We know. So AI is I don't know. I don't have the opinion of the AI. I always have opinion of everything. I'm joking. I have opinion, but the AI is difficult to say. My opinion is probably it will take over at some point every computer job. But it will take time, of course. So we have a little bit time. And it all depends on the people who are developing the AI, if they're pushing in certain direction. For example, they're pushing in the direction of making the AI draw better than a human, and they made it. Now, if they push to the direction of the AI making 3D characters better than human, if they push on that direction, they will probably make it. If they don't, it'll be fine. So we don't know. Nobody can tell you. Nobody or no one. Here I need to find some reference because it's a little bit strange. This has to go like this. Probably it will happen like this. Since this is kind of a stylized characters, we need fewer folds, but in nice places. That's why I'm doing something, then I'm refining, then I'm smoothing some folds if I don't like them, then I'm making others. I'm just doing this until I feel it's looking good. Of course, it's better to try to find references about this. And also we have a concept, but in the concept you cannot quite see, and also the concept artist is doing this very, he's doing it from one angle, so he's doing something that looks kind of okay. From other angles, it's different, and it's, basically, it's easier for the concept artist many times. I have to do it to look good from all sides. So the folds has to be very logical. They have to come from logical places, go to a logical places and stuff like this, which is not facile. And facile, if some of you are not Spanish, is easy. In Spanish. Hi Nico and guys, anyone use the Gaumon S630 drawing tablet? Would you recommend it for beginner level? Gaumon. I think Gaumon was contacting me once. Let me just wait a little bit. I will see something here. If it is Gaumon, I'm not sure. Battery free graphic tablet. Yes, it was Gaumon. And the tablet is still here, you know. So, Gaumon contact me. Let me hey, we cannot see the logo here. This is the up. Yeah, this is the Gaumon logo. It's very difficult with. Let me show you the tablet itself. The tablet itself looks very nice. It looks like Intuos, almost. This Gaumon tablet. I don't know what the Gaumon tablet is. This, let me see. Is M10K battery-free graphic tablet. So, the 2018 version. So, they wanted me to review this tablet on my channel. And I say, okay. So, I put this tablet instead of my tablet and started to work. But it turns out, this tablet has a lot of issues with two monitors. Yeah, who knows? Who knew? The pen is pretty cheap looking. But they have here some accessories like a glove, for example. This is a glove. But I don't use it. I just put it in the shelf and I forgot about it. Because I told them about the issues. They gave me some drivers and stuff to try. Nothing worked. There was a huge issue with this tablet with the two monitors. And I decided not to do the review. And I asked them for an address to return the tablet. They never gave me an address, so the tablet is still here, you know. Yeah, I have a Gaumon tablet. Who knew? Who knew? But I don't recommend them, so yeah. I would say if you want to be sure that the tablet will be okay and it will work and everything, buy a super entry-level Wacom tablet. Wacom is one of the oldest companies that makes tablets, maybe the oldest one. They know what they're doing. And the entry-level tablets won by Wacom, not Wacom One. Wacom One is a display tablet, it's expensive. One by Wacom, buy it, and probably you can watch the video of tablets that I have done, what tablet I'm using and why. It's on my other channel, and you will see what happens. Now I'm using the one by Wacom tablet for more than 2 years now, I think. Yeah, I bought it in the beginning of pandemics, so I can just put it on my backpack and work. Then I just unplugged my Intuos tablet and plugged one by Wacom tablet just to try it, to see how it works. And then I never plugged my Intuos again. I'm working with the one by Wacom tablet forever now. Yeah, it's pretty small. It doesn't take place on my desk. You can easily fit it in your backpack. It's super convenient tablet. It has 2000 pressure levels, which is completely enough for sculpting, as you can see. It's a very, very cool tablet. And it's not expensive, especially secondhand. You can find it almost new, or completely new even, because some people are giving these tablets for gifts. Since they are not very expensive, they're buying new tablet, giving it for a gift to somebody. This somebody doesn't use it ever, so they sell it secondhand for less money, and you can buy it for pretty cheap secondhand. That's my advice. Haha, dude, very impressive Spanish. Please, can you say "que hubo pirobo"? Is what's up, dude? "Que hubo pirobo" in a Colombian accent. Even if AI can draw skill better and faster than human, I think their style is very repetitive and boring. I can almost always tell if somebody was drawn by AI. But you see, AI making characters from concepts will make the character from the concept, and the 3D character from a concept. So, boring or not, it will be from this concept. And if the AI can do it, then it will be good. Nico, do a contest and give away the tablet. I don't think I have a right to do so, because, you know, in order to give away the tablet, I have to have the permission of the owners of the tablet. I don't own this tablet in my head. This tablet is not owned by me. I don't pay for it. I didn't do anything for it. They just sent it to me for review. I refused to make the review. And it's just here. I don't consider it mine. I don't consider it mine. So I'm not giving it away. I'm not selling it. I'm just sitting here, just like this. We'll see until then. Until when? Huion is good too, though it's cheaper than Wacom. Probably, but the cheaper Wacom probably is better than the similar level price Huion. In terms of quality, I don't know. I cannot say. I have the same tablet. I use it for 2-3 years and it worked fine even with two monitors. I don't know, maybe something with my setup, but still, if it doesn't work with my setup, it will not work with some other people's setup. So I cannot recommend it, you know. If it worked very good for me, I would recommend it. I would say it works very good, it's very good from my perspective. And maybe somebody else will suffer from it and say, Nico, you stupid guy, you recommended this tablet, it doesn't work for me. But I don't have power over that. But whatever, it's fine. I think you could have done the review just telling the truth. It's good for us to know. And you could have more free to review from another brand. I don't know, if I make a bad review, which this would be a bad review, definitely, how the other brands would trust me to do a good review for them, you know? I was contacted by Asus maybe 1.5 years ago, I'm not sure. Maybe it was last year. I was contacted by Asus to make a review of one of their laptops. It was a laptop made for creators to make 3D on anything. I think it has touchscreen and many things. It was a good looking laptop. And they say, make the review and then you will keep the laptop, for example, or something like this. There are two things why I didn't make the review. First, they wanted specific things. So in certain timings of the video, you have to show the tablet and how you work on it. So it seems a lot like an advertisement. They show me a sample videos, and I imagined me making this type of video, and it's It seems to me like I'm selling myself. It's visible that you're selling yourself making this type of video, you know? And I didn't want to do that. Not for just a single laptop. Maybe they have to offer me more. Maybe. But with my level of subscribers, I mean, my subscribers are low level now. I'm like 28,000 in this channel and 77,000 on the other channel, I'm not sure. They cannot offer me too much. If I had like maybe 300,000 on 500,000, maybe they can offer a lot more money, who knows. But doesn't matter. They wanted the video to look too much like an advertisement. If they want me to mention a couple of times in the video that I'm using this product, just vaguely mention it, it's okay. But they want a lot of things. And they have the right to do so, of course. They want to advertise their brand. But yeah, it didn't happen. The other reason was I was having a laptop already, and my laptop was more powerful than their laptop. So yeah, I didn't need their laptop at all. And that also played a role, of course, to not sell myself. Yeah. We psychopath people, if I may say so, are kind of always taking care of our well-being, we may say. I want to make those things. So for this detail here, I need to make only this part and the middle part. The others I will, you know, mirror. So it's not very difficult. How to make it? Let's see. Let's go to object mode, deselect everything, and go to front view. Then I will go to Dave, to my folder, and drag this image here. So the image now is in here. Now we can go and make some polygons to make this thing here. There are certain ways you can do it. For example, I can make a cube. I can subdivide it a lot or dynamesh it small. Then I can make this with a mask, this design, and extract the mask. It's always valid. But the more accurate way, I think, will be just to make it with polygons. So I will just add with Shift A plane. Then I will take this plane up in edit mode, and probably I will leave it here, just turn it 90 degrees on this angle, on this angle, make it smaller. Then I will select this guy and put it in the middle, kind of. Select this plane, go to edit mode, make it smaller, but I don't want it to be that small. So I will enlarge this guy a little bit, so it's similar to our model. Okay, it's enlarged. Now, where is the plane now? We cannot see it. Let's turn it a little bit, press home, and see where is the plane. I will push this back a little bit, so the plane is... it's gone. The plane is gone. The plane is gone. The plane is gone. Hold the plane. Hold the plane. Plane is gone. But there's a smile on your face. Hey, hey. I can see the sun. I can see the sunlight. Ooh. I can see the sun. I can see the sunlight, and the plane is gone, but we find it. I want to learn topology, please tell me where to learn. Learn topology someplace else. I don't know topology. No, I'm joking. Of course, you can watch the course on my other channel, which is a full game character course with topology and everything, but mostly you can just find images. For example, if I want to make a nice head topology for animation and everything, I write in Google good head topology, and there are certain images, and you will find, just take this image, put it in your pre-ref file like I did I think, let me see. No, I just watch it from my other monitor. It's not here. But yeah, it's that's, you know, good topology for ARM, for example. You write it in Google, you do it. This is a rope. Oh, this should be a rope. I don't like it. So to make this a rope, it will not be ultra difficult, because I will take this edge, these edges, detach them, convert them to curve, and then I will make this curve a rope. At least that's the plan. We will see if it will work. But let's continue here. Let's continue with our plane, which was gone, but now it's found. I'm going to learn 3D art and animation soon in a community college because it's hard for me to learn independently. But up until now, I've tried to learn sculpting a little bit on my own. Good. Let's say you have access to both premium big display pen tablet with a VESA arm and a premium graphic tablet. Which would you use in your sculpt workflow? Since the beginning of my sculpting experience, I'm using graphic tablets, not display tablets. I'm more comfortable with the display tablet. Probably I can learn using a display tablet easily, and maybe it will be very nice to use, but it's a big investment. So if I have it for free, probably I will try it for a couple of 100 hours just to see how it works and if I can handle it. And if not, I will sell it. But to buy one, I will not, at least for now. Nico, opinions on new ArtStation profile design. Like everything new, in the beginning, I hated. But the ArtStation profile design, the new one. But probably in some, with the use, we will get used to it and probably I will like it at some point. But now I don't like it. Hello from Vietnam. Hello, Vietnam. Are there any benefits on HDR display in 3D modeling you know of? No. AI at the moment only gives us references, but does not deliver the real 3D. It makes a recipe for a cake, but does not know how to cook it and bring it to real world. 3D artists are the cooks. We'll see. My friend tell me that topology is easy to learn, but boring to do. Is he right? Yes, he is. Hello from Australia. Ooh, Australia is here. That's, interesting. Australia, cool. So yeah, very cool. Now, I am going to use the points. Put it in the right places. And then extrude, rotate. And now, the boring part of this stream is coming alive, you know. This is the boring part. So if you leave now, because this is the boring part. And you will see, this seems, manual to do these things. Seems like a lot of work. It's not. It's not that much. It's a bit boring, but it's not a lot of work. It's just work, some work. You don't have to be afraid of this that much. I was afraid of this. And I admit it, but not anymore. I chose to not be afraid. I chose to not fear. Fear is something kind of destructive. It can be useful sometimes, but most of the time it's destructive for your nervous system, for yourself, for your rational thinking, of course. It's destructive. And yeah, if I have to be rude, I would say that religion is using fear to... Well, yeah, let's not go there, you know, it's useless. As I said, I will not convince anybody of anything. So why should I try, you know? Not of anything. I can convince you of things that you know I'm an expert of. But religion is not that thing. I'm not an expert on religion. That much. If I read the Bible completely, because I know some things from the Bible, but I haven't read it completely. If I read the Quran, I'm not sure if it's correctly pronounced Quran, not sure. But the Muslim Bible, if we may say, then maybe I can pretend to be an expert on religion, or to at least be more familiar with the religion. Now, not so much. I can't. Although I can, but it will be stupid. And I'm not saying I'm not stupid sometimes. Everybody is, in certain occasions. But at least we are trying to not look stupid, you know. That's, again, our pride, our ego. Oh, I cannot be stupid. I'm so smart. I was the smartest kid in my class. We cannot say that. I mean, you could be the kid with better grades, but smartest, you don't know. That's difficult to say. Even with IQ tests, you cannot say you're the smartest. There are different types of smart. There is a street smart, there is a IQ test smart, and there are other types of smarts. So, almost everybody can be smart in their own way. But remember that the psychopaths usually are very smart. They are not stupid. It's difficult to be stupid and to be a real good psychopath. Like a clinical psychopath, you know. Hello from Turkey. Turkey is good. Have you done haircuts before? Do you have any videos on how to do haircuts? I have done even a course with haircuts back in the days for Victory 3D. Victory 3D is another company. So the first company that I did courses for was Victory 3D. The Victory 3D is one girl from, she's from the Philippines, but she's living in the United States. And she's also a 3D character artist. So she hired me to do courses for her. And I did a couple of courses for her. And then I started doing courses for Nextooth Education. And my best courses then was for Nextooth Education. And I learned a lot from both Victory 3D and Nextooth Education to make SpeedChar, like my own brand of courses. But what I changed with my brand is that I'm showing my face to all my courses. Not many teachers are doing that, which I found weird because, you know, this is something very normal for people to see your face while you are teaching. This is more personal. You can find my courses in the description of the video, of course. And all my courses are with my face, remember that. So if you don't like my face, probably you will not like my courses. It's just, they come together, you know. My courses, my face, it's the same. Maybe it would be easier with the skin modifier to do that. Maybe. Hi Nico, what's the advice would you give a freelancer newbie? I always give advices to freelance newbies, but freelancer newbie is difficult. You have to push it to work in a company at least a couple of years before you get freelance. Before you go to freelance. Nico, if you were to make a visual novel game, would you use Blender or Dust3D? Dust3D will be probably faster. So maybe Dust3D, if I have to do it. Blender will be very slow to do this. Every character you have to sculpt separately and stuff. But I will never do that probably, so it's fine. This type of modeling can be boring sometimes, but it's very useful. I like how it gives precision much more easier than sculpting. Yeah. But isn't that fear guiding you to not look stupid? Probably. Salam. Salam alaikum. Salam. Haircuts. Nico, do you know Abby Lil? Probably not. Nico, have you ever done lace clothes with transparent parts? I'm a little confused how to do it. I have never done that. I think probably some alphas would have to be used or some faking just with the texture. I don't know. I understood haircuts, thinking you were going to get a haircut. No, haircuts. Cards. I miss those old cours of Nico doing realistic characters with ZBrush. I learned a lot and uses his shortcuts and advices even today. Good. Good to know. But ZBrush is no more for me. I have gone the freeway. This is the freeway. Blender. Freeway. Or the highway. Namaste, brother Nico. This is Sri from Bharat. Good Sri. Beast Sri. Hello Nico, does your sculpting skills have something to do with the shampoo you use? I don't think so. I don't think so. I'm not saying completely no. I'm just saying I don't think so. Maybe they can have something to do with my shampoo. But nowadays I'm using a shampoo for dandruff, you know, because my skin is falling off. Like something like a leper or whatever this disease was. No, it's just the little tiny flakes that are falling off. But with the right shampoo, it's better. Probably it's because of the food I'm eating and how I eat it. These days I'm trying to eat just once a day. Big meal. Today I ate, I think, 5 pieces of bread. 5 slices of bread with mayonnaise, with mozzarella, and half grilled chicken, and one cucumber, and some nuts. Usually that's what I eat these days. I'm trying to not eat sugar, and probably I will have to eat some sugar at some point. Sugar is kind of... I am made to eat sugar. But everything has to have moderations. Sugar is very, very easy to just get a lot of it. Sugar, like all things that are bad for you, that are addictive... Sugar is addictive, definitely, that we cannot argue about that. Sugar is addictive, and like every addictive thing, you can overdo it very easily. And these days in the stores, when you go inside the store, you have so much choice about your sugars. You can eat chocolates, pastas. Pasta is this kind of a dessert we have here. Many people have it, many countries. But when I was in Argentina, by the way, I love the alfajor. Alfajor with dulce de leche. Amazing, amazing stuff. This was amazing. There are alfajors from Milka. And I think those were very good. Alfajor is a dessert which is like this big, round. It looks like a cylinder. It's usually with 3 pieces of something like a biscuit. And then in between you have dulce de leche, and sometimes it's covered by chocolate. The whole thing is covered by chocolate. So it's just ultra delicious. And dulce de leche, if somebody doesn't know, it's ogurche moloko or something like this in Russian. It's milk with sugar. Something like a syrup. It's something like a cream. Dulce de leche. Or dulce de leche, maybe in Italy, in Italian, who knows. You are no Russian language. I know Russian, kind of, yes. Hi Nico, why Maya is invaded Ukraine? No, 3D Max invaded Ukraine. That's what I said in the beginning, you know. But Nico, do you know if we eat only once a day, our metabolism can be slowed and make us fat? Some people say it's not true. Some people say if you have a prolonged periods of hunger, so if you eat less than you need a day, then your metabolism will slow down. But if you eat once a day, but a lot, so the whole calories you need in one day, you eat in one sitting, then your metabolism will be okay. I can get rid of my 3 coffee cup a day. No way I'm going to take it without sugar. I'm not mad enough yet. Yeah, it's cool. I don't drink coffee, by the way. We miss Blue T-shirt Nico. Yeah, Blue T-shirt Nico is the good guy. I am the bad guy, the Red T-shirt Nico. Pasta is very popular here in Brazil too. Exactly. We have alfajores in Uruguay. Dulce de leche. Exactly. Alfajores, I think they are in Argentina. Uruguay probably. I heard that there are some in Spain and Philippines, because the Philippines were very Spanish at some point. But I'm not sure. I was in Spain a couple of times. I didn't find any alfajores there. Unfortunately, I love alfajores. This is one of my favorite desserts in the world, with the Turkish baklava, by the way. We have a lot of Turkish baklava here in Bulgaria because we have a lot of Turkish people here. But when I was in Turkey, in this hotel, it was fresh. It was just super fresh Turkish baklava. And wow, this is... If you don't like sweet, the Turkish baklava is ultra sweet. And it's so good. But alfajor is also good. Yeah, all countries have... nice desserts. I have eaten Indian desserts. I don't know what they were, but they were delicious too. There are a lot of things in different cultures that are very nice with sugar. Подскажи, актуални ли си част 3D артисти по персонажи в Game Dev Company или лучше работят на фрилансе? So, this guy is asking if nowadays 3D character artists are, you know, in companies are a thing. Yes, of course, 3D character artists are working in companies like 2 years, 5 years, 10 years ago. So it's the same. Nothing has changed. And working in freelance is good, but you have to have the work ethics and you have to be good. And usually I recommend people to go in the beginning, even if they have the skill, to go work for a company for a couple of years. And when they're working in a company, if they have freelance, they have to get it. And then working in a company, having a freelance also. And then if they think that the freelance is enough for them to leave the company, then to leave. But because relying only on freelance from the start, it's pretty difficult. I don't need Google anymore. Nico is my knowledge. Exactly. Turkish baklava, come on, Greek baklava. Ah, because you are Greek, yeah. Many people say that, for example, moussaka. We call it moussaka. In Egypt, they call it moussaa. In some countries, they call it, but it's... in Bulgaria, many people think that moussaka is Bulgarian dish. If you go to Turkey, they will say, ah, oh, moussaka is our dish. If you go to Greek, they say, ah, oh, moussaka is our... thing. So, you know, you cannot pinpoint exactly the things, but baklava is something that came from Arab world, I think. So, Turkish baklava nowadays is cool. Of course, the Arab countries, I guess they have also baklava. I'm sure they have. I believe her name is Corazon Brian from Victory 3D. Exactly, it's her. Both her Garoshork skill course, but my result look wacky. Any course recommendation for the foundation? For the foundation of what? I mean, my courses, you can learn Blender, you can learn ZBrush. I have courses for both. I have courses for characters, for anatomy. Whatever you want, you can choose from my courses. If you don't like my face, then don't buy my courses, because I said that my courses have always on all the time my face is on. Real time, you can see my face, how I'm talking and working at the same time. It could be a bad thing if you don't like bald guys with one eyebrow. Many people don't. Many people don't. But many people do, so that's why I sell courses. It's cool. Saludos desde Colombia. Saludos, Colombia. Colombia, by the way, they are speaking very nice Spanish. Slow and very understandable. In some other countries like Costa Rica, for example, you cannot understand anything. What? In Colombia, they're speaking like they're trying to teach you Spanish, you know? They're speaking slow, calm. Maybe not calm, but slow and understandable. Colombia. Oh, what was your favorite food you tasted when you came to Brazil? Brazil. In Brazil, I don't think we tasted too much local food. Yeah. So I cannot say exactly. We mostly bought things from the street, just some things made with dough. Like bready breakfasts. We have a lot of those things in Bulgaria. In Greek also they have them. In Turkey, here in the Balkans, we have a lot of these bread breakfasts. With meat, with cheese, with whatever, some things. So I think we ate mostly that. When I was in Brazil, we didn't have too much money, so we didn't go to restaurants that much. But always when we go to a certain country, we try to eat local food. Because why are you going to a country and eating McDonald's, for example? I don't get it. I just don't get it. But Americans get it. They do it. They go to a certain country and eat McDonald's. By the way, if you go to Japan, to Tokyo, McDonald's there is different. They have different types of things in the McDonald's. So it's worth it to eat at least once there. My friend just got stolen a relatively expensive car in Bulgaria and it was a private parking. Yeah, this happens. My car was stolen this year. They stole my wife's car, which I also drive sometimes. It was not a good experience. And of course, they returned some of the money from the insurance company. But at the end, we had to buy another car. And when we, you know, draw the line, we were a couple of €1,000 behind. But that's life. Alfajores can be found everywhere in Spain, but they are sold only in November, December. Ah, they're Christmas candies. Anyway, alfajores in Spain are different from the ones in Argentina. Oh, I didn't know that. Pavo de Cuello. It's because when we don't take drugs, we are calm. Problem. Hamburgao. I've taken many courses, but I never seen you using Polybuild. I think it's helpful. Probably. I take a course to learn how to sculpt your face. I like your job so much. Congratulations. Thank you. So you learn how to sculpt my face. Ah, so you are taking the course, but you're not looking at the course content. You're looking only at my face and trying to sculpt it. That's an interesting way to use the course, by the way. But it's okay. It's okay. How companies look at 3D generalists? Is they think an amateur artist or professional artist in your perspective? 3D generalist is either professional or amateur depending on their quality. You know, I have seen not so many generalists that can do characters, environment, animation, rigging, and VFX even. So those guys are very rare and they are considered super professionals. They can do all those things. And they can do it in a good quality. But most of us are not that wholesome. So we can do only one thing good. Which is characters. In my case. Do you use Substance Painter? Because haven't seen you use it. Do you have course on that? I have two courses in which I show Substance Painter very well. One is the course... Let me show you if I can. Okay. This is the what I earned, by the way, from the courses. But the course is this one. Create a commercial 3D game character in Blender for course. I show a little bit of Substance Painter here. In this one, ZBrush Blender Substance Painter with the Fox. I show Substance Painter. And this is absolute beginner substance painter course. So I show a lot of substance painter there because this is the course for substance painter. This is how I see my courses and what they earned for the certain month, you know. See, this course is doing very well, by the way, with the heads, $300 and something, which is great. And those courses here on the bottom, this one, unwrapping, is just $12. It's sad. But it's normal. This course is not doing super hyper well. But others are doing great, so it's fine. Have you been visited Southeast Asia countries? If so, which most impressed you so much? Southeast, you say. So south is down, east is there. Okay, I've been to Vietnam, China, and Japan probably is not southeast, so yeah, it's more like northeast probably. But I've been to Japan, China, Vietnam, and Thailand, and I like every country has its own, and also I haven't seen all of Japan or all of China, if it's impossible almost. And all of Vietnam, for example, all of Thailand. I've seen just certain parts. In Thailand, I've seen some islands, some very nice sea, like, views with a lot of small islands there. It was amazing. And the food in Thailand, just amazing. In Vietnam, we have seen also a lot of things. Also, the Dragon Halong Bay. Halong Bay was wow. And also the river in the middle. Then we went to an island. We've seen a lot of things. So in every country you can find something very beautiful, and those are huge countries, a lot of things to see. My experience cannot describe just even like 1% of the countries at all. Come visit us in Egypt someday. I was in Egypt a couple of times. You're gonna love malokia, also known as green soup, with chicken and rice. One of US ambassadors says she loved Egypt for this. Yeah, we've been to Egypt. Of course, it was not the real Egypt because we were in this 5-star hotels near the sea in Hurghada. Maybe 4 times we were there, 4 years in a row almost. Yeah, we haven't tried probably this super local foods. Although in the hotels, sometimes they have Egypt nights where they cook Egypt food and we kind of try different interesting things. So probably I have tried that. Do your Blender character courses help people to learn Blender, or should I avoid those courses till I learn Blender first? Yes, I have 2 courses with the mouse and with the rabbit, in which they're beginner courses, absolute beginner courses for Blender. So you can learn Blender from those courses. For coloring model, what do you suggest? Texture, palettes, or materials? I usually color my models with vertex paint. And then this vertex paint, if I make a low poly, I transfer this vertex paint, I bake it into the low poly as a texture. But for the high poly, for this one that I'm doing right now, I will use vertex paint mostly and probably some materials too. For example, for the gold parts, I probably will use gold material here in Blender. And because this is only for presentation, this will be for 3D printing, the model itself. But for presentation, they want it colored. So I will use some mix of some things. High speed char. You motivated me to go back to sculpting Blender. ZBrush is really good, but its UI is not made to be understood by humans. And with Blender, I can anything in the same place. Yes and no. ZBrush, if you kind of try to learn it, and if you study it, you will find that it's amazing tool. I will add a cylinder, by the way, in the same mesh. It's a super, not Blender, ZBrush. ZBrush is amazing tool. The only drawback of ZBrush, in my opinion, is not that it's the UI. It's because it's paid. That's the only, oh, not 90. Come on, 90. Yeah, it's paid. I don't like that. I don't like that it's paid. That's it. Everything else, it's cool for ZBrush. And yeah, I'm amazed with Blender. And Blender is just this free tool that's so cool. I don't know. Love the transparency with the monetary side of things. Yeah, it was accident, and I just played with it, you know. I didn't meant to show you those things, but it's fine, it's fine. You know, what can happen? What's the worst thing that can happen? Hello, Nico from Montenegro. Ooh, Chernagora. We call it Chernagora. Thanks you so much for courses. It's great. Love the transparency with the mod. Okay, yeah. Do you know 3D artists that work for big studios that happen to be 2D artists as well? Yes. Most of the very good 3D artists, character artists that I know, they also draw very well. And before that, they were just drawing. They were 2D artists. But not all of them. So it's a question of whatever. I mean, if you are a 2D artist, it's good. You can go to 3D and you will be good pretty quick. But if you are not, you also can be a 3D artist. It's not a problem. Nico, can you take a look at my ZBrush theme in the general discussion channel? Yeah, I saw it with the blue buttons, but it's everything is subjective. I mean, some people like blue, some people like yellow more, so it's subjective. Or orange. Someone said that Blender being free is bite because she spent $1,200 on add-ons. Yeah, but I didn't, and I'm still making characters and freelancing with Blender without spending any money. The only money that I've spent theoretically was to buy the Quadrimesher add-on. And in reality, I didn't spend any money on it. I contacted the guy. I told him that I will make a course using the Quadrimesh. And I asked him if he will be willing to give me some discount for my students, for example, for me to give to my students. He said that this will be a very difficult thing to do, almost impossible. But he said that he will give me the Quadrimesh for free because I am using it in my course and I am kind of advertising it. So I get the Quadrimesh for free, so I haven't given any money for Blender plugins. The only money I have given regarding Blender is I donated, I think last week, 20 euro to Blender. Just a simple amount, but just to release my conscience a little bit, because I'm making money from Blender. I wanted to just give them a little bit of a gratitude, just to buy some coffee or something, because nowadays 20 euro are not a very big amount of money. Do you have some books you recommend for Blender? No, I haven't heard somebody learning from books these days. It's always videos and, you know, video lessons, tutorials. In ZBrush, just so you can append a 3D model, I have to add a sphere. Just so I can append the 3D model, I have to add a sphere and then append the model over that sphere. Why? This is how it works. I don't know. Have you ever tried Nomad Sculpt on iPad? No. I'm using it on my phone. Glad it isn't subscription and just one-time payment like $20. Yeah, I paid for it. I have the paid version of Nomad Sculpt and I'm using it very rarely when I don't have internet, for example, and I want to entertain myself. I'm sculpting a head, for example, in a plane. Because only in a plane I don't have internet. In French as well, facile. Yeah. Facile is in Spanish, easy. Henico, how much do you think I should be making to live in Netherlands? Ooh. Don't ask this question. In Netherlands. Are you crazy? Netherlands is very expensive. I don't recommend you to live there. But I'm joking. Of course, probably you can live with like, let's say 3,000 euro, but below that, it probably will be not good. At least 3,000 euro, at least. Netherlands is expensive. Other countries, not so much. Why? Come on. Okay, X faces. But, hey. What's happening here? I want to select only those guys. Without selecting this guy. Okay, I deselected it now. Probably. Yes. X faces. Good. Now select those. X faces. Sometimes even Nico cannot handle it. Now, I will select this face. Inset. And X faces. And then go to the front view. Amazing. So, I'm not following the artwork completely now because it's a little bit distorted. So I will do it not distorted. And yeah, that's why. You know, I would ask the restaurant for Egyptian cuisine menu. Also, if you can try to bring back with your ceramic called in Arabic, Kila, I think it's going to be a very interesting subject for your sculpt. Probably. A cloth question. How do I make Miori folds? I don't know. You have to just watch the Miori folds and make them. Just from, you know, look at them. Now it's supposed to be a ZBrush for iPads. I wonder how it will work. Who knows? I'll only work if you have a ZBrush subscription on PC. Ah, okay. Baristool Church. Baristool Church, yeah. Barstool. Alt and X to toggle X-ray mode. What would you say is the best way to learn Blender to a good level for freelance, in your opinion? What would be a best way to learn Blender to a good level to freelance? You know, learning Blender to freelance, I don't think it's enough. You have to have other types of skills also. Just with Blender, probably you can, but I don't know exactly how you can do it. So, I cannot exactly help, but you can learn with tutorials and everything. I learned Blender, basically, by just watching tutorials in YouTube, mostly. Now, what Nico will do is add a mirror modifier. But since this is not exactly in the mirror, what Nico will do now is move this in certain direction. I don't need to move this in certain direction. I will do this. Go here and change the origins to... what is this? Oops. I cannot catch this. Okay, G. No. Oh, I'm changing the origins of this guy. Okay, we don't want that. What we will need is select only this. Now I think it selected only this. Okay. Now the origins, it's down. I'll move it up. And then pull it in this direction until it fits. All right. Yeah, it's difficult sometimes, but it works. Okay, go now. It's kind of okay. We'll see, we'll see. Maybe this I can move. I'm selecting them with L. Move them a little bit aside, so they are more like it. And in order to put them down also, we can do something else, but not now. Now, I have to concentrate on this, the pizza slice. But not only on the pizza slice, we have to concentrate on finishing this video because it's already a lot of, like almost 2 hours, or yeah, it's 2 hours and 3 minutes even. So we have to finish this and I will continue by myself, alone, in the dark. Yeah. Thank you, thank you, thank you for all you inspire. Thank you very much and bye for now. Yeah, we end this boring stream and we continue in the next one, which should be not so boring probably.